Sidekick, Jack Dalton, George Eads. Come on out, guys. Very excited about this because we remember the show.
Right, yeah.
But my first question to you guys is, do you guys remember the show? Like, were you, like, even born?
Yeah. Yeah, I was waiting for it, yeah. I actually wasn't, no. No, I wasn't for the first 2 years, and then after that.
Have you?
I was very born.
You were very born? You... Yeah, I was very, very,
very, very born. Yeah.
Super very born. So did you watch a bunch of episodes of it, though, when you were preparing?
I did. Yeah, well, once I got the part, I started... I mean, I watched reruns when I was a kid. My dad, we called him MacGyver when I was younger, so he really is.
Is that
MacGyver.
Right?
Oh, man. He used to hijack my class projects and do them himself. So I said that in some press interviews, and he showed up to set, because we're shooting in Atlanta, where I'm from. So
right, right, right.
He shows up, and he brings one of my old class projects that he hijacked.
Oh, that's
hilarious.
And
framed it himself.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
He brought his MacGyvered class project to MacGyver's set.
Yes. Everything you just said. Correct.
Do you guys MacGyver in real life? Do you like, you know, are you very good at DIY and all that
man.
Kind of stuff?
Thank goodness I play the character that doesn't have the big brain. My closest thing to MacGyvering anything was probably when you put the playing card in the spokes of your bicycle with
that
clothespin and made it sound like a motorcycle. That's about it. Yeah.
I'm only MacGyver in the kitchen. My husband's not MacGyver anywhere. Are you a MacGyver kind of person?
I like to think I am, but the truth is a little different to my my idea. I give it a shot, you know, I give it a shot. It doesn't always work out the way I wanted it. But one thing that I like is that you're MacGyvering the mullet back into fashion, my man.
Oh, yeah, bring it back the mullet.
I'm trying to, at least. It's a little, awesome. It's not enough business in the front. I'll get it there, but it's definitely partying in the back, yeah.
Bumps or bruises playing MacGyver yet?
Oh, man, yeah. I mean, stuff that you probably don't want to hear about right now because it's a food show. But, yeah, it's...
It got that ugly.
Chafing. Lots of chafing, actually. Yeah, yeah. The backs of my legs were, like, bleeding from these pants. I was just running. I mean, you saw it in that. It was actually the shot that they just showed. And I was running. For some reason, the pants were a little too tight or something. And it was all kinds of weird stuff, blisters on my feet. But because they gave us these amazing shoes, these boots. I got this leather jacket on. It looks, you know, iconic.
You look cool, and it sounds good on paper until you get home. You're like... Man, I'm one blistered, chafed mess.
Yeah.
All right, so we're gonna play a fun MacGyver game.
Yeah.
Come on over.
Come on.
All right.
All right, so you guys are gonna get a chance to MacGyver a big pile of junk, and what we want you to do is take 1 minute to try and turn this pile of junk into an airplane.
An airplane?
Not you, Curtis, we're the judges.
No, I know.
They're the pros here.
I told you guys about the playing card, right?
All right, well, listen, we're going to split up the audience. You're playing for this half. You're playing for that half. And the winners... No pressure. The winners are going to go home with a really cool prize. The winning half of the audience goes home with the iHome vanity speaker. It has built-in Bluetooth and a speakerphone, hands-free conversation, and they're worth $149.99 each. So try.
All right.
Okay.
So wait, again, what am I doing here?
You're gonna take 1 minute and you're gonna make an airplane out of the junk that's underneath this burlap. Curtis, you ready?
On your mark.
60 seconds on the clock. Go!
Go.
Thank you.
That's a Boeing 747 right there.
Well, I think we all realize one thing. You guys are very good actors.
This is how much you should appreciate them when you're watching MacGyver on CBS, of course, at 8 p.m. Wow, you are extremely fine actors. I would say that it's a tie. These are both terrible. So that means... Please, it's my show. I would have cheated anyway. Everybody goes home with the prize. Watch their show.